Vintage Pretty, they had their bumps and bruises. Really, both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to
check the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.
I'm ready for more.
If you fired up, I'm fired up.
Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3. Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready. I'm ready for more.
Game time.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready. I'm ready for more.
I just got 20, I'm running on empty. There's more where that came from, my money is silly. I feel an envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more.
Oh, it's hard in the field, yeah, we
tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more.
The home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. Set to get us started, and off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This taken in at the goal line, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Right out of the gate, we're going to get a delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Here's Hurts to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett, and he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing, but to give him this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position, and to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. And Faking the give to Mostert. Now Lance sliding out of the pocket. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. And this is going to be incomplete.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
The 49ers are going to turn over the special teams crew. The field goal unit is out there now. The kick by Gold is good. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
Taken at the goal line. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw here. Left side here to Sanders. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion. They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep.
And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Looking here for Smith downfield. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 32 yards. Zone now. They'll look to throw. And this is caught in the end zone. Jalen Reagor there to make the grab. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number one. Drive number two leads them right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back. Tremendous poise. Confidence never lost. And obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
Elliott good on the extra point. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act.
There he goes, left side.
You thought you had it.
Touchdown, 49ers. Trent Sherfield, 75 yards. And once again, the 49ers are back out in front. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that, man. One play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
Scott on the return, out of the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Good drive last time, really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why?
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
Throwing again on second down. Hurts. Flush to his right.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
10-7 our score after one, right here on EA Sports. They'll look to throw here on first down. Airing it out deep for Smith. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he gets it down deep into San Francisco territory. A big play there for Philly. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Once again with Sanders, and he'll take it into the end zone. Sanders, a 6-yard touchdown run, and the Eagles have retaken the lead. Elliott Good with a PAT, and the lead is now 14-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook.
Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get down for the sack. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Lance, he'll swing this out to Mostert. Just falls short down at the 1-yard line. So that's about as long a non-scoring play as you're going to see from inside their own 10 to first and goal. Mostert will get into the end zone for a 49er touchdown. So the first drive ended This time they take it down and punch it in the end zone.
So that first drive felt like they were just gathering knowledge, didn't it? Just enough to kick the field goal on the first one. And the second time they put it all together and got it all the way to the end zone.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 17-14. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Scott on the return, out of the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Steps, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. So after the sack here, second and 14. Looking to throw. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
They'll look to throw now on first down. He'll fire deep for Rager. And this is caught. Toes inbounds there. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Elliott now to add the extra point. It's up and good to make it 21-17. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Throwing on first down is Lance. Escaping the pressure right. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Throwing now is Lance. And they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. Gets around him, and he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Draw play here. Lance hands to Mostert. A gain of three. Second down. Lance going to throw. Being chased out left. And Lance will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact there at the end of the play. They'll run with Mostert. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Time with Mostert, and he gets it into the end zone with no time left in the second quarter as they take the lead. So it was the passing game that got him.